Hello, my name is Mike Dean. Our first time meeting. This is Diamond Shamgar. She has quite the story to tell. Before I get to the story, I first want to ask, exactly how did you feel the second you found out that Bunny and the Hall of Honors wanted to honor you?
I was ecstatic. I mean, I do the work in the community just because I feel like I'm supposed to do. It's just like my contribution from being within the community. So to be honest, that felt really good.
And I'm going to say this. She's definitely been a part of the community. But then she unfortunately contracted breast cancer. But fortunately for the rest of the world, she used that as motivation to help everyone else. Tell us about that.
So I was diagnosed with breast cancer November 2022. But prior to that, I was fighting in the community against this disease, bringing awareness for over a decade. So it wasn't an option whether or not I was going to share my story. And I was transparent with our community, and I got the support that I needed. And we continue to fight and push on and advocate and support one another through their journeys.
And this is what you call a hero, a shero. This is when you live the fairy tale. What people don't understand about fairy tales is the protagonist always goes through hell before the happily ever after comes. Her happily ever after is here. It's coming. Diamond, we so appreciate you. Before I let you go, what do you got coming next that you are proud of?
What's next is we have a fourth coloring book that's coming out, which is teaching kids to be aware of cancer, what to look for, things of that nature. And we have our survivor's journal that's out now.
All right, so Diamond Shamgar, we're sitting here at the Hall of Honors. I can't wait to see her grace the stage, walk across that stage. She's going to float, you could tell, happily. Here we go, Hall of Honors, out.
Our next honoree is a mom, a wife, and the founder, and now a breast cancer survivor. Diamond Shamgar. She created the Breast Cancer B440 to bring awareness to women who also was diagnosed with breast cancer before the age of 40. She has founded the Shades of a Cure Incorporated. For over a decade, she has been doing a phenomenal job. It's a nonprofit organization whose mission is to bring cancer awareness to our community. Her motto is something I love. Don't give up on yourself. Life is going to knock you down, but it's up to you if you want to get up and keep swinging. Would you please give a thunderous round of applause for our Harlem honoree, Diamond Shamgar. Come on, Harlem.
Thank you. I'm going to ask you guys to bear with me. This is my first time giving a public speech, but I am living in one of my answer prayers. When I was diagnosed with breast cancer in November 2022, I prayed to God that He prepared me to speak my story, to tell my story far beyond my voice, far beyond my sight. I wanted to reach many, many people, and here I am on the biggest stage in Harlem, the Hall of Fame. So I want to say thank you to Bunny and her Harlem Honors team for recognizing Shades of a Cure and myself for the work that we do within the community. I founded Shades of a Cure, a cancer awareness organization, in 2010. And the purpose was just to bring awareness to the community, to provide care and resources to our people. You know, I like to think of it like FUBU, right? It's for us, by us. If we don't take care of us, then who's going to take care of us? So since 2010, I created three children's coloring books to inform kids what cancer is, to teach them what it is, created two survivor's journals. I was featured in Self magazine, a documentary. And for our cancer survivors, we offer a financial assistance grant. All right, so we're giving back. We're here giving the resources, giving the information, letting everyone know that we're here to support them throughout their journey. And we are so grateful that you have allowed us to be a part of your lives and your journey. So the moments of gratitude, the moment I found my purpose, every time I get a chance to do something for the community, those are the moments that I want to remember forever, that I want to hold on to. Never want to forget my purpose. So some people often ask me, how do I keep a positive mindset? And it's simple. I just claim victory. I pray it, I sleep it, I breathe it, I speak it. Everything is victory. In life, we're gonna have those obstacles, right? Sometimes it's gonna knock you down, right? But you gotta get back up. And when you get back up, you gotta swing. Because you got one life to live, and you cannot allow nothing to take you down. So I thank God for showing me favor every day and waking me up every day and giving me a chance to continue to push forward and bring awareness to our community. To my family, my friends, the Shades of a Cure community, I thank you guys so much for your prayers, your daily messages, all of those things that uplift me. To my children, I love you. Please look around. You are in a room of Black excellence. This is who we are. I pray that you never, never, never forget who you are, your value, your importance, what you bring to the world. Be proud of yourself, and most importantly, be happy. So what I want to do is I want to challenge everyone here in this room. We often say, you know, give this person their flowers while they're here. And while we all appreciate it, because I do, right? I want my flowers while I'm here. I'm encouraging and I'm challenging all of you guys to get in the field with me. Let's plant those seeds for the generations to come. Let's fill them up. Let's give them the things that they need so they can be great and they can be better. So, Bunny, the Harlem Honors team, thank you again. I truly appreciate it. My family, thank you again. I love you guys. Thank you.
Great motivation, huh? Great motivation. Once again, Miss Diamond Shamgar.